This video is based on the elephant herding optimization algorithm. We can use this algorithm to solve different optimization problems. In this video, we will try to understand what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, various steps used in this algorithm, mathematical models to update agent's position in the search space, and algorithm flowchart. Step by step, we will try to understand this algorithm and how we can find out the optimal solution for optimization problems. First of all, as you can see here, elephant herding optimization algorithm is introduced in 2015. It is a nature-inspired population-based meta-heuristic optimization algorithm that is basically inspired by the herding behavior of elephants in the real life. So this algorithm is basically inspired by the herding behavior of elephants in the real life. Elephant herding optimization algorithm provides better results when it is compared with other meta-heuristic optimization algorithms, and it provides better results when it is tested on different benchmark test functions. So we can use this algorithm to solve different optimization problems. So as this algorithm is inspired by the herding behavior of elephants in the real life, so first we will try to understand the elephant's herding behavior in the real life so that we can easily understand algorithm virtual simulation. First, you can see here elephant, that is the largest land mammal on the earth, and you can see this is the elephant basic body structure. They have massive body, large eyes, large ears, long trunk to pick objects for water drinking, for bath. Next we have teeth. Elephants use their teeth to protect their trunk and sometimes to find water underground. Elephants use their teeth to dig holes. Next, you can see here, elephant skeleton have 326 to 351 bones, and elephant maximum body temperature is 36 degrees Celsius, and they can communicate using sound, sight, touch, and smell. Next, you can see here we have African bush elephant. African bush elephant is considered as the largest elephant species worldwide, and African male elephant height, you can see here, 304 to 336 centimeter, and female height about 247 to 273 centimeter. Next we have Asian elephant, and male Asian elephant height 261 to 289 centimeter, and female Asian elephant height, you can see here, 228 to 252 centimeter tall. Now we will try to understand elephant's behavior. Elephant's behavior modeled in this algorithm using two operators. First operator, you can see here, clan updating operator, and second operator we have separating operator. And in this algorithm, two operators are used. First we have clan updating operator, and next you can see this is the separating operator. Now we will try to understand this operator in the real life. So we have two operators, clan updating operator and separating operator, and here you can see in the real life, for clan updating operator this behavior is modeled, and for separating operator this behavior is modeled. Now we will try to understand elephant's behavior. As we know that elephant live in the groups in the real life, you can see here we have elephant group. Inside elephant group, you can see we have four clans: first clan, second clan, third clan, and fourth clan. Elephant group is composed of several clans, and in each clan we have female elephants and their cubs. You can see in the each clan we have female elephants and their cubs, and in each clan we have older female elephant as the clan leader. So this is the first behavior that is modeled as clan updating operator. Second behavior you can see here, as you can see in the clan we have only female and their cubs, there is no male elephant. So second behavior is based on male elephant. Female elephants prefer to live in the family groups, but male elephant live in the isolation. Male elephant social life is very different. They either live alone or with other male elephants. So here you can see we have clan updating operator and separating operator. Clan updating operator is based on elephant group behavior, and separating operator is based on elephant, male elephant isolation. For algorithm simplicity, different assumptions are used because real life is quite different than the virtual environment. Here you can see we have the virtual environment, and you can see we have virtual agents, or you can say virtual elephants. So different assumptions are used in this algorithm for the simplicity. First assumption, as you can see here, that we already discussed here in the clan updating operator. As we know that elephants live in the groups, and elephant group is composed of different clans. You can see here elephant group, and we have different clans. It is assumed that each clan has fixed number of elephants. So this is the first assumption, that each clan has fixed number of elephants. For example, you can see here we have clan 1, clan 2. In the clan 1, you can see we have 3 elephants. In the second clan, again we have 3 elephants. And here you can see elephant population, or you can say elephant group, that is composed of different clans. And in the elephant population, we have 6 elephants, or you can say this is the population size. For the elephants, female elephant in the group interact with other families or other clan members, but there is no strong bond between the elephants in the group because family group splits after becoming too large for the available resources. Next assumption you can see here, another elephant behavior is modeled in this algorithm that we discussed here as the separating operator. Here you can see we have elephant groups. Male elephants leave their family groups and they live alone or with other male elephants. So in second assumption, it is assumed that in each iteration, fixed number of male elephants leave their family groups and live alone. So in each iteration, we will replace only fixed number of elephants. Next assumption you can see here, as we know that female elephants spend their entire life in the family groups under the leadership of older female elephant. Older female elephant is considered as the group leader. You can see here we have 4 clans, first clan, second clan, and third clan. And in each clan, you can see we have fixed number of elephants. And next, you can see in each clan, we have one old elephant as the clan leader. Female elephant is considered as the group leader until death. And after female elephant death, her eldest daughter takes her place. So this is the third assumption, that there is an female elephant leader in the each clan that leads the elephants in each clan. You can see here in each clan we have older female elephant as the clan leader. Now you can see here we have different steps used in this algorithm. First, we will initialize the algorithm parameters, then initialize elephants population in the search space randomly, and then we will check whether the current iteration is less than maximum iteration or not. After that, we will sort the elephant population, and next we will update elephant's position. We will replace the birth elephant in the current population, calculate the fitness values, and again we will increment the counter, and we will repeat this loop. When the stopping criteria is met, we will display the optimal solution that is found in the previous iteration. Now step by step we will try to understand this algorithm. First step, you can see here, first we will initialize the algorithm parameters, that is search space dimension, lower bound, upper bound, fitness function, that is the cost function we are using here, maximum iteration, that is how many times the loop will repeat, and elephant population size, that is the total number of search agents we are using. Next, you can see in the step 2, we will initialize the population randomly for elephants in the search space. Here you can see, suppose we have 50 elephant, that is the population size, that is 50. So we have 50 search agents, or we can say 50 elephants. So for 50 elephants, you can see now their position, x1 denotes the position for the first elephant, x2 denotes the position for the second elephant, x3 denotes the position for third elephant, up to you can see x50, that is the position for the 50th elephant. Next we will check whether current iteration, that is 1, maximum iteration, suppose we have 1000, whether this condition is true or not. Right now you can see this condition is true, so we will move to next step, that is sort elephant population. So first we will calculate the fitness values for the elephants in the current population. Here fitness function is used to calculate the fitness values, and after that they will sort the elephants from best fitness to worst fitness value. So here you can see we sort the elephants using the fitness values that we computed before, and then we will sort them from best to worst. Step 5, you can see here, for all clans in the elephant population. Elephant population is composed of different clans. For example, you can see here we have 2 clans, and in each clan we have 3 elephant, so population size we have 6. So we have 2 clans, it means we will repeat this loop 2 times, and in each clan you can see we have 3 elephants, it means we have population size 6. So you can see here this loop is from 1 to 2, as we have 2 clans. And next you can see here J, it means elephant. So for all elephant in the clan, we will update the older position and we will calculate their next position. So here we have total, suppose 6 elephant. In the 2 clan we have 3 elephants, so J is 1 2 6. Next we will update the elephant position, and then we will check whether the new solution that we found is equal to the best solution that we obtained here in step 4, whether it is true or not. After that we will update the older position if this condition is true. Next you can see here how we can update the elephant older position. As we know that elephants live in the clans under the leadership of an older female elephant. Here you can see the new solution, or you can say the new position that we are going to calculate for each elephant is influenced by the leader, that is the best elephant, or you can say group leader. So here you can see the next position that we will calculate for each elephant is influenced by the group leader, and this is the older position, elephant older position, and here this is the random value, and here you can see the alpha, that is random value between 0 and 1. After that you can see, so when the position is updated, we will check whether the new solution is equal to the best solution or not. If this condition is true, then we will update the position and generate new solution using this equation. Here you can see this is the center of clan. New individual is generated by the information obtained by all elephants in the clan. You can see here NCI, it means the total number of elephants in the clan. Next you can see we have second operator, that is separating operator. For separating operator, we will consider the elephant's fitness values that we computed in step 4, and we will replace the burst elephant in the clan in the separating operator. Here you can see J represents elephant from 1 to total number of elephants in the clan, and here we will replace the burst elephant in the clan. You can see this is the burst elephant, lower bound, upper bound, random value. After that again we will calculate the fitness value for each agent in the current population, and then after that again we will find out the fitness values for new solutions that we updated using clan operator and separating operator. And after that again we will select the best solution among all, and then increment counter. Increment the counter, that is current iteration is equal to current iteration plus 1, and right now current iteration is 1, so 1 plus 1 is 2. So right now you can see condition is true as 2 is less than 1000. So again we will repeat this loop. Again we will sort the elephants based on their fitness values, and we will sort the elephants from best fitness value to the worst fitness value, and again we will perform the clan operator and separating operator. So this is the flowchart for this algorithm. First we will initialize the population for n elephants in the search space randomly. After that, using cost function, we will calculate the fitness value for each elephant in the current population. Next, based on their fitness values, we will sort elephants from best elephant fitness value to worst elephant fitness value. After that, we will use the clan update operator to find out the next position for the elephants, and then we will perform the separating operator where we will replace the worst elephant in the current population. Next, again we will find out the fitness values for the new solution that we calculated here, and then again we will select the best among all, and then we will increment the counter. If stopping criteria is met, then stop. If stopping criteria is not matched, then we will repeat this loop from here. And so we will repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is met, and once the stopping criteria is met, display the best solution that you found in the previous iteration. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.